Evansville, Indiana is known as a test center or a test hub for restaurants. And one big downside of that is we mainly get fast food where when you're in the drive-thru, it's a minute, 30 seconds, a minute, you've got to be gone. They're all about time. It's not about quality. It's not about anything but time. So in a city that's so focused on time, one thing that you constantly are losing is the quality of the food that you're receiving. And with that, it's also price. So one of the things that we've noticed in the city of Evansville is that fresh food is much more expensive in a fast food restaurant. And families in poverty are more likely to order something from the dollar menu versus a salad or a wrap that's healthier. So to kind of solve that problem, we brought you Boxed, which is our problem pain, which I just explained, is that people are living in poverty. They don't have fresh food. They don't have vegetables. They don't have fresh chicken. But our main focus is the fresh vegetables because they're one of the healthiest things you can eat. So 9,000 families in Evansville received SNAP benefits last year, and overall there's 27,000 families in poverty just in Evansville. So our solution is a food box that contains fresh veggies for the elderly, because they are one of the groups that just cannot get to fresh vegetables. They don't have cars, transportation is lacking, and they don't have the internet to order. They're very limited on options. So one of the biggest things that we found from talking to Dr. Linda White is seniors that live in low-income, high-rise buildings, they have kitchens, but in those buildings, they don't have a dining hall. So it's up to them to create these healthy meals, and some of them, they don't know how. So another option that we're looking at is having recipe cards and saying, hey, take this lettuce and add this and you'll have a salad, or take the zucchini and make it into noodles and you can have a healthier pasta, because they don't know how to do that. It's not easy. And we're gonna partner with Seton Harvest on the west side of Evansville and buy a plot of land for about $675 and grow our own vegetables, so that way we cut down costs and we're able to give more for a lower price to the seniors when we take in their SNAP benefits to kind of help cover our costs a little bit, since over 50% of our income is going to be from SNAP, so we'll be eligible to accept it. So, passion on the challenge.
Okay.
So, as far as our trends, there's about 36 food pantries or food banks in the Evansville area. With those food banks, most of them are run by churches. And in that, they focus on non-perishable goods such as canned goods, things that aren't going to go bad quickly, so that they can stockpile those up and then later on give them to the families that need them. They do focus on the sustainable goods, and with those food banks, there is a lack of marketing. So not a lot of people know that there are so many food banks in the Evansville area that do the things that they do. So doing the research that we did, I didn't know personally that we had the upper 30 range food banks, so that was something new to me, and that goes to show you just a lack of marketing. Also, since 2010, there has been a decline in the marketing for families with low income to get those foods, so it's another thing that we were trying to focus on, get our marketing out there, let people know that we're here to help those families out. And what makes us different? These food pantries, they provide, like I said, the free non-perishable goods so that families don't have to worry about paying for them. They're going to have something to eat at least once a day, whether it be just the bland, regular foods that you might buy for the 50 cents at the grocery store in the canned goods area, or whatever they have in their stock. And then our company is going to provide those low-cost veggies. Like Hallie said, as we grow them ourselves, it's going to be a lot easier for us to obtain those rather than have to wait on farmers like we looked at before. We looked at just getting the ugly vegetables from the farmers. This vegetable garden will allow us to be able to efficiently obtain those veggies without having to waste any time getting them out to those families.
So we definitely believe that Boxed is a great opportunity. There are a lot of grants that are out there for organizations that are trying to help aid in food insecurity. Also, accepting SNAP benefits will help cover our costs and will help our target market, which doesn't have a lot of disposable income. Also, we talked to a company that is delivering to elderly and disabled people food for free in Massachusetts. And they have found that they have grown over the last 17 years from 5 people that they were delivering to up to 140 now. So there definitely is a market and a need for this. Additionally, our end user is low-income seniors. So, and by talking to Dr. Linda White, we've learned that these people have some of the poorest health, so they really need these fresh vegetables to improve their quality of life. So in conclusion, we would like to give you our value proposition, which is for seniors who live in low-income housing, Boxed provides affordable fresh vegetables delivered to their door. Unlike food pantries and food banks, Boxed provides fresh options that are accessible to these low-income individuals. So thank you for taking this into consideration.
All right. Thanks, guys.
Thank you.